Good afternoon. I'm Natalie Pober. We welcome our viewers in the United States, Canada, throughout the world to Fifth Third Arena in Chicago, Illinois for the first matchup in the Magellan Corporation Women's Hockey Showcase in conjunction with Billie Jean King Enterprises. This week, the best talent in women's professional hockey has come together for the first time in Chicago, including 35 Olympians. The Magellan Women's Hockey Showcase is part of a larger effort to develop a sustainable professional women's hockey league in North America. The Professional Women's Hockey Players Association is committed to making hockey more inclusive for women today and for the next generation of female hockey players. The PWHPA stands with the NHL as together we try to make hockey for everyone by providing a safe, positive, inclusive environment for players, coaches, families, regardless of race, color, religion, national origin, gender, disability, and sexual orientation. We would like to thank our sponsors, Magellan. Magellan Corporation is the leading global distributor of high-quality specialty steels and other metal products. Since 1985, Magellan has been an industry leader with an innovative approach to supply chain knowledge and technology expertise. Deeply rooted in a culture of caring for its employees, clients, suppliers, and shareholders, but also for the greater community and citizens, Magellan strives to make a positive impact on a local and regional scale. Magellan Corporation is honored to support numerous deserving charitable organizations with a diverse range of causes. As tennis title holders and social activists, Billie Jean King and Elon Kloss live their lives according to the principles of equity, empowerment, and access. They have both excelled as professional athletes, run companies, sporting franchises, and have significant experience in reputation management and legacy building. Their company, Billie Jean King Enterprises, includes individuals from consulting, marketing, and financial services with the aim to generate revenue from helping companies, leagues, athletes, and organizations commit to making impactful change. Billie Jean King is a sports, social justice, and equality icon. Notes Bob Arthur, CEO of Magellan Corporation. When she and Ilana Clausen approached us to support women's hockey, the fit was natural. We are already proud partners of the NWSL's Chicago Stars and NWBA's Chicago Star. Let's level the playing field for women and girls sports. We would also like to thank Adidas, Bauer, Dunkin' Donuts, the NHLPA, and BioSteel. We have our youth skaters out at the moment. We will have our ceremonial puck drop coming up shortly. Let's listen in. Again, we would like to thank the Magellan Corporation. Especially Bob Arthur for hosting us and the Blackhawks for hosting us at the Fifth Third Arena and for their hospitality.
Now first, let's meet our officials for today's game. Michael W. Verdick, Joseph Gazzardi, Michael Robinson, Haley Yates. Fans, please join me in welcoming our PWHPA Youth Players of the Game, Kate and Ella Shorberg from Chicago.
This is exactly what this game is all about, providing opportunities for future generations. We have
Ladies
two players on the ice.
Join me in welcoming Team Hefford.
We're going to welcome Team Hefford. Who will be in the red this afternoon.
And now, time to meet the stars of Team Hefford. The defenseman, an Olympian from Hamilton, Ontario, and Clarkson University, number 4, Bridgette Lockett.
Lockett, be one of your defensemen.
From Quebec and the University of Minnesota, number 9, Catherine Duell.
Number 9, Catherine Dow.
A 3-time Olympian from Regina and the University of Wisconsin, number 12, Megan Mickelson.
Number 12.
An Olympian from Ontario, Megan Mickelson. Clarkson University, number 14, Renata Fast.
Renata Fast, another forward.
From Ontario and Clarkson University, number 23, Erin Ambrose.
Number 23,
Ambrose. From Ontario and Clarkson University, number 27, Josanne Busbon. An Olympian from Ontario and Dartmouth College, number 7, Laura Stacy. From Ontario and Colgate University, number 13, Jesse Elridge. A 2-time Olympian from Quebec and McGill University, number 15, Melanie Dupuis. From Ontario and Cornell University, number 14, Hannah Burton. An Olympian from Ontario and the University of Wisconsin, number 20, Sarah Nurse. From the University of Wisconsin, number 26, Emily Clark. A 3-time Olympian from Quebec and Boston University, number 29, Maria Philippe Pouille. From Ontario and Boston University, number 37, Rebecca Leslie. From Quebec, Canada, and McGill University, number 39, Anna Sophie Batiste. From Ontario and Clarkson University, number 32, Cassidy Sauvé. She is a 4-time Olympian from Finland and the University of Minnesota, number 41, Dara Ratu. The coaches of Team Hefford are Jana Hefford and Christy Alcorn.
We will
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Team Hefford.
Coming up shortly.
Now time to meet Team Dupuis. A 2-time Olympian from St. Anne and the University of Minnesota, number 3, Jocelyn Wolkoff. A 2-time Olympian from Quebec and Cornell University, Lorianne Rogo. A 2-time Olympian from Ontario and Cornell University, number 8, Laura Portino. From Ontario and the University of Wisconsin, number 22, Melissa Channel. From Ontario and Connecticut University, number 25, Emma Greco. From Ontario and the University of Western Ontario, number 51, Caitlin Gosling. A a three-time Olympian from Ontario and Cornell University, number 6, Rebecca Johnston. An Olympian from Nova Scotia and Cornell University, number 11, Jill Slonier. From Ontario and Boston University, number 12, Veronica Bach. From Quebec and Boston University, number 16, Sarah Lefford. A two-time Olympian from Ontario and Cornell University, number 19, Brianna Jenner. A two-time Olympian from Ontario and the Ohio University State, number 24, Naylin Spooner. From Ottawa and Clarkson University, number 26, Jamie Lee Rote. From Ontario and Clarkson University, number 36, Lauren Gable. An Olympian for Nova Scotia and the University of Wisconsin, number 40, Blair Turnbull. A two-time Olympian for Quebec and Providence College, number 31, Giovanni Lacus. From Alberta and Harvard University, number 38, Embrace Malschenmeyer. Team Dupuis is coached by Lori Dupuis and Christy Alcorn.
We will have starting lineups shortly.
Please direct your attention to center ice for today's ceremonial puck
drop. We will have our ceremonial puck drop.
First, please welcome one of the most exclusive forwards to ever play in the game. She is a five-time Olympian, a four-time gold medalist, a seven-time world champion, and is a member of the Hockey Hall of Fame. From Trenton, Ontario, Canada, Jaina Hefford. Joining Jaina for the puck drop today is one of her longtime teammates. She is a two-time Olympian, a gold medalist, and a three-time world champion, hailing from Williamston, Ontario, Canada. Please welcome Lori Dupuis. Team Hefford and Brianne Jenner of Team Dupuis, please skate to the center to join today's ceremonial puck drop. Thank you.
And we will turn to the flags for the American National
Ladies
Anthem, the Canadian National Anthem, and the
rise,
Finnish
move your hats
anthem.
For the playing of the Finnish and Canadian National Anthem.
have puck drop coming up. Three great renditions, each national anthem. One more time, we'd like to thank our sponsors, Magellan Corporation, Puck drops. It'll be number 40, Turnbull, who has the faceoff. Now, Team Hefford. Excuse me, that was Team Dupuis. Took the puck away. Team Hefford drops back. That's number 10, or 14, Fast. Fast chips the puck deep. Team Dupuis chips the puck out. Now number 12. Team Hefford has the puck. Puck is chipped near the blue line, played off the near side boards. Puck is behind Team Dupuis' goalie. Number 27, Team Hefford scramble in front of the net. Number 24, Spooner kept the puck. Now number 3, puck is chipped off the boards. Team Dupuis is coming away with the puck. Number 36 for the puck, and the puck is taken away. Shot on net. It'll be gloved. Face off toward the near side boards. Eldridge chipped the puck deep for Team Hefford. Number 4, Marquette, for the puck, chipped the puck deep. Puck is being played in the near side corner. Number 8, Fortino had a tip, but the tip was wide. Team Dupuis brings the puck out to neutral zone. Puck is played by number 19, Jenner. Jenner on a shot, but the shot was wide. Now number 37 came away with the puck. Number 15 for Team Hefford. Opportunity, but the puck was swat out of the way. Team Hefford will have to back check, and that will be icing. As Ambrose went for the puck. Now Pauline will take the faceoff for Team Hefford. Pauline chips the puck near Mashmeyer. The puck will speed out of the zone. Now Ratu played the puck. Team Hefford plays the puck D to D behind Ratu. Puck will be kept in Team Hefford zone. Poulin attempted to keep the puck in. Puck played out to the blue line. Number 15, Dow, kept the puck. The puck is now played to the slot. No one was home for the puck. Now Mickelson passed the puck to Clark. Clark will come away with the puck. Clark passes the puck up to Nurse. Nurse over the blue line and through the neutral zone. Nurse keeps the puck, has possession, and almost goes toward Mashmeyer. Spooner with a beautiful feed, and that'll be a goal for Team Dupuis. It'll be Johnston who lights the lamp first for Team Dupuis. Turnbull with the faceoff against number 13, Eldridge. Turnbull kept the puck in until it bounced into a bench. Turnbull with the faceoff. Turnbull kept the puck in. Now number 24, Spooner, the puck. Now Fortenot played the puck deep. Fortenot kept the puck. Puck is taken away. Now number 37 keeps the puck.
Team Dupuis goal number
and that
six,
will be Leslie.
Johnston.
Colleen plays the puck on the near side board, number 15 for Team Hefford. That'll be Dow. Puck is played, now number 5. That'll be Rigo. Now Dow plays the puck D to D. Puck is played toward the neutral zone. Poulin plays it over the blue line, passes the puck ahead to number 39. The puck is taken away. Now the puck is played in the near side corner, taken away by Team Dupuis. Puck is played on net and it's gobbled up by Ratu. Puck is played out to the blue line, played behind Ratu. Puck ricochets off the near side board, wheels it through the neutral zone. That was number 26, Clark, just received her national championship ring from the University of Wisconsin, September. She had the banner raising ceremony a few days ago. That was Patty Bones. Puck is played. Line change. Team Hefford. Leslie chases the puck. Puck is kept in Team Dupuis' offensive zone. Spooner tried to backhand the puck to our offensive zone. Was unsuccessful. Now Doust chipped the puck in deep. Puck is played along the far side boards. Hustle for number 6. It'll be Johnston who scored a few minutes ago. Spooner wheels it through the neutral zone, passes it to Turnbull. Turnbull loses the puck. And Fortino takes a spill. Played in the slot. And Ratu swats it away. Puck is blocked. Greg Grew blocks the shot. Almost a backhand with an empty net. One-timer attempt that went wide. Puck is in Team Dupuis' offensive zone. Spill by number 39. Now Rattray passes a D to D. Rattray had the pass back to her, and that was number 39. Fast with a pass in the neutral zone. Puck is played deep. Good block by Team Hefford. Now number 15 keeps it in, and the puck is taken away and circled along the boards. Puck ricochets onto the stick. Fragu. Now number 14 fast passes it up ice. Number 15 backhands it to Team Hefford's offensive zone. Puck is played behind Mashmeyer. The puck played up ahead. Number 12 had the puck pop up. That will be Bach. Scrum on the near side board. Bach will hang on to the puck as she dangles through traffic. Bach attempts to keep the puck. Now number 12 keeps it in. Now Nurse passes it up. Puck is being played Team Hefford's offensive zone. Now number 15. Now Turnbull takes the puck away. Number 4, Laquette, attempted to keep the puck. Puck is played through the neutral zone over the blue line. Johnston plays it to no one, but the puck ricochets to the stick of number 19, Team Hefford. Pass to number 4, Laquette. Jenner plays the puck ahead. Had the puck taken away from her. But number 26 attempts a shot. That was 36. Now Jenner will take the face off. Team Dupuis. Now number 14, fast. Pass it to Pauline. Pauline up the ice. Dow chips it deep. Number 39 for Red plays the puck. That will be Bette. Now 26 plays the puck. Pauline plays it over the blue line, drops it back to Ambrose. Ambrose couldn't get her stick on it. Dangle attempt by number 7, Stacy. Comes number 16 with a 2-on-1. That'll be a cross check. Number 23 for Black. We'll head to the penalty box. So power play. For Red. Puck is played to the blue line, kept in by number 3. Puck is chipped out, no icing. Puck is played by Mashmeyer. Spooner regroups Team Dupuis. Puck is played ahead, no one was home. That was intended for Laquette. Now number 3. be LaRock. And that'll be a power play goal. It was Ambrose in the penalty box for Team Hefford. Score is 1-1. Should be 2-1, excuse me. Pauline gets tripped up. Puck is played toward the blue line. Puck is ricocheted off the near side board fast.
Team Dupuis goal for number 24, Natalie Spooner.
That will be Spooner's goal.
Assisted by number 19, Breanne Jenner. Time of that goal is 9:36. Time of that goal is 9:36.
Puck is played the corner fast, trails number 12. Puck is taken away by Team Hefford. Number 3, LaRock, comes away with it. Spooner dangles behind Ratu. Spooner comes up with the puck as she dangles through traffic, loses the puck. Puck is put on net by Turnbull. Ratu did not know where the puck went. Team Dupuis back checks. Number 3, LaRock again. Team Hefford comes away with it. Nurse plays the puck toward the blue line, passes it up. It'll just go off the glove. Mashmeyer, right in back of her net. Puck is played up, but ricochets off of Gable's skate. Gable will retrieve the puck. Or excuse me, that was Fortino. Puck is played by Jenner. Number 37 had the puck. Now number 26. 36. Puck is kept in, but the shot was wide. Dowse cherry picking. Bette passes it in the slot. Backhand attempt. But Mashmeyer blocks it and stands tall. Dowell, with the back check, passes it up to Pauline in the neutral zone, taken away by Sonier. Sonier tries to put the puck on net, but it's blocked. Dow chips it ahead. Puck is wheeled through the neutral zone. Dow plays it behind Mashmeyer. Now number 12, Bach, came away with it, but was shoved to keep the puck in her defensive zone. Stacy had the puck shot on net, and it was turned aside by Mashmeyer. Ambrose plays the puck on the far side board. Now Team Hefford will have to regroup. Fast comes away with the puck, wheels it through the neutral zone, dangles, keeps the puck in, attempts to play it in the slot, but no one was home. Fast circles back. Attempted to cycle along the boards, plays it toward the blue line, that's Patty Bones. Patty Bones will have to back check. Turnbull with a jump. Gets set up near the blue paint. Puck coming the other way. Leslie chips it in deep. Mashmeyer plays the puck to Spooner. Spooner attempts to play the puck out. The puck was blocked off the stick of Pauline. Dow plays it ahead. scramble in front of the net, and Mashmeyer falls on the puck. Face off near the far side board. Dow passes it ahead, but the puck is going to be taken away by number 26. Puck is played far side boards. It's going to be a face off. Team Hefford's offensive zone. Dow will head toward the bench. Puck is taken away. 2-on-1 coming up. Nurse, the wing of number 7. That was a good play, good heads up play. That was Stacy who had the shot. And good block by Mashmeyer. Puck is circled behind Mashmeyer. Battle for the puck. Number 16, and that'll be face off toward the near side. Won't be a face, it'll be a penalty. For number 14. Fast. Score so far. It's 2-0. Favor of Team Dupuis. Now number 5. Rougeau. Had the puck. Puck is chipped deep. Mashmeyer. Plays the puck behind her goal. Puck is played ahead to Jenner. Jenner wheels through the neutral zone over the blue line. Spooner has the puck. Puck ricocheted. Raju plays it in it. Puck is turned aside by Ratu. Gable with an opportunity, but it's turned aside. Puck is played near side corner. Being pried from along the boards. Puck is played out to neutral zone. Team Dupuis will regroup as both teams have a quick line change. Now number 8 plays the puck intended for Turnbull. Turnbull retrieves the puck. Laquette attempted to play the puck. Puck is chipped deep. And Mashmeyer plays the puck, passes it up to number 3. Turnbull plays the puck over the blue line. Ratu plays the puck, chips it off the glass. Turnbull attempted to pry it out. Bach in the slot, and it's turned away by Ratu. Puck is being kept along the boards. Puck trickles beyond the blue line into Team Hefford's offensive zone. Team Dupuis back checks, regroups. Power play winding down. Back to full strength. Fast comes out on the ice. Now goes to the bench. Puck was intercepted by Ambrose. Oh, Clark! It's an opportunity. It was blocked. Several players in front of the net looking for their net front opportunity. Pierce pokes it ahead. Now Dow retrieves the puck. Now number 12 cuts back. Passes it up to Clark. Clark played the puck to the far side board. Turnbull turns away and heads to her offensive zone. Now number 4, Laquette played the puck. Puck is long, far side board. Turnbull tries to chip it toward the blue line. Puck is being taken out by Leslie. Fortenot drops it back. It's met by several members of Team Dupuis. Pauline pirouettes. The puck was played to Mashmeyer. Mashmeyer gets a stick on it and it's turned aside. Team Hefford cuts back, circles the puck along the board. 1 minute in the first. Team Dupuis leading by a pair of goals. Now Fortino circles the puck, intended to keep the puck in. Now Fast, just in the penalty box, tries to dangle it. Puck is played ahead, and Ratu will cover it up. 35.7 seconds left in the first. Folks, stay tuned for an intermission interview. Have a special guest coming up. Puck is rung around the boards. Now played toward the near side boards. Puck is played by Jenner, who couldn't get through traffic. Number 26 goes down. His puck is being played near the blue line. It's kicked in. Jenner miscues, and the puck is taken away. Puck is dropped back the far side board, and that'll do it for the first period. Team Dupuis leading 2-0. We will have an interview coming up. And we welcome you back for the second period. We apologize for the interview. Unfortunately, we did not have an interviewee, but we will have more coming up. Team Dupuis is leading 2-0.
Team Dupuis back onto the ice.
We'd like to thank our sponsors. We'd like to thank Magellan Corporation for bringing the Women's Hockey Showcase to Chicago and for creating such an amazing opportunity for these accomplished female athletes. Magellan Corporation is a proud partner of the Chicago Red Stars and the Chicago Sky. Taking the face off. Pauline plays the puck along the boards. Fast. And Ambrose gets to the puck. Now number 15, Dow, passes it to Fast. Pauline over the blue line, plays the puck ahead. The puck is blocked. Pauline in the blue paint, and no one is there to put the puck home. Fast. Chips the puck along the boards. Spooner backhands the puck out. In the zone, the puck trickles to Team Hefford's zone. Puck will be played back. Now Ambrose plays the puck ahead to her offensive zone. Puck is misplayed, chipped over the blue line. Now Gosling plays the puck deep, plays the puck behind Ratu. Puck is being played ahead by Stacy. Stacy played it to Nurse. Nurse with a backhand attempt, mad scramble in front of the net. Mashmeyer did not know where the puck was. Puck is being played out. Now behind Ratu. Puck flips toward Ratu's net. Here comes Stacy over the blue line. Chips it deep, hits the glass. Line change for Team Hefford. Now Team Dupuis comes back the other way. Gable has played the puck. Now number 4, Laquette, came away with it. Team Hefford will attempt to keep it in. Now number 9, Dow, had the puck. The puck is now chipped deep. Laquette will cherry pick at the blue line as Leslie chips it behind Mashmeyer. Puck is kept in at the blue line, and that will be caught by Mashmeyer. Nice control by Team Hefford as they stay in their offensive zone. Number 15 for Red. That will be Dow. Face off. Team Dupuis regroups. Pete passes the puck ahead to Dow. Dow dangles one-handed. Puts the puck in the blue paint in the slot. Mashmeyer, and that'll be a goal for Team Hefford as they get on the board. That will be Pauline. The goal, but we will have confirmation. Turnbull with a face-off for Team Dupuis. And Team Dupuis will come back the other way. Puck is being kept along the boards.
Team Hefford will hold number 29. Now be Poulin.
Poulin with the goal. So number seven, Stacy, plays the puck. Puck pops out. Good stick by Eldridge. Eldridge chips it deep. One-on-one, here comes Leslie. Leslie with the deke, and she scores! She ties it up! Leslie ties the game up for Team Hefford as they come out hot. Puck will be played to Leslie. Eldridge moves ahead with speed.
Team Hefford goal number 37, Rebecca Leslie.
The puck is being pried along
time
the boards.
Time 16:22.
Leslie heads to the bench. Fresh legs for Team Hefford. Now, Fortino passes the puck ahead. Good heads up play. That'll be a tripping call. No, I said tripping, no penalty. Face off just outside Team Dupuis' defensive zone. Chanel is cherry picking. Puck taken away by Ambrose in the slot. Fast. Now Bette plays it up to Dow. Dow around Mashmeyer's net. Fast. About to back check to get the puck. Peugeot loses the puck. Line change for Team Hefford. Puck is played up to Saunier. Opportunity there. Gosling keeps the puck in on the blue line. Saunier plays near the slot. Puck is taken away to Stacy. Stacy chips it up to herself. Puck is being played in the far side hash marks. Now the puck is being played up. Here comes Spooner, who had a goal earlier this game. Spooner loses the puck to the far side corner. Spooner's offensive zone. Nurse looks for the puck. Puck is intercepted by Spooner as Nurse goes down. Leslie takes a knee. Puck is being played. Here comes Nurse. Nurse chips it in deep as Team Hefford goes for a line change. Puck ricochets off the board to Johnston. But number four, Laquette, chipped it up high and wide. Puck played by Spooner to Turnbull. Turnbull played it to Spooner. Spooner backhanded it. Ratu played the puck behind her net. Puck is played to Laquette. Dow had the puck as Gable fell to a knee. Gable was the 2019 Patty Kazmer Award winner. It's given to top player in Division I hockey. Ref jumped out of the way. Foot race here. Poulin tries to put it on net, but someone got their stick on it. Poulin retrieves the puck. As Poulin goes down. A whistle. And it'll be a power play for Team Hefford. as Lil Rock will take a seat in the penalty box. So Team Hefford has an opportunity to put one on the board. Nurse will take the faceoff for Team Hefford. Jenner for Team Dupuis. Johnston cuts back. Greco passes it. D to D. Long shot will spin around the boards. Gratu plays the puck behind her net. Puck is being played up. Lee, that's fast. Fast chips the puck. Plays it down low. Team Hefford looks to regroup. Ambrose. One-time opportunity played in the slot. Stacy could not get her stick on it. Puck is cleared. Line change for Team Hefford and for Team Dupuis. Hefford waiting for another teammate. That would be Ambrose. Now number 12 for the red team. Puck was almost shot out. Mickelson keeps the puck in at the blue line and cherry picks. Opportunity there. Mad scramble near Mashmeyer, and that'll be a whistle. As multiple people went down. We'll have a face-off just outside of Team Hefford's offensive zone. It'll be Jenner against Pauline for the face-off. Jenner for Team Dupuis, and Pauline for Team Hefford. Ratu plays the puck up ahead to Laquette. Laquette keeps the puck in at the blue line. Shot from the blue line, mad scramble. And Mashmeyer turned the puck aside. Mickelson plays the puck down low. Dow looks for an open teammate, chips the puck to Mickelson. Mickelson back to Dow. Dow turns and pirouettes to Laquette. Laquette had the puck clear. Now LaRocque has an opportunity. LaRocque with the spinorama, and it's blocked by Ratu. Here comes Clark. Clark, two on one opportunity. Clark with a goal! Her second of the game. Puts Team Hefford ahead. Number 12, Mickelson against Clark. Puck is passed to Clark. Now number 12 for Black. Bach will carry the puck in into the slot. Fast backhands the puck out. Stacy attempts to win the foot race. Stacy was knocked down. She was in the slot near the blue paint. Chanel. Nurse with an opportunity, and the puck goes off of Mashmeyer's glove. Number 5. Rougeau cut back. Puck is lost. Dropped it back for Leslie. Leslie played it. One-timer opportunity, and it's stopped by Mashmeyer. .45 left in the period. Team Hefford leads Team Play 3-2. Ambrose to Laquette. Laquette plays it deep, right behind Mashlin.
Team Hefford goal for number 26, Emily Clark. Time that goal was 10-3.
Turnbull.
Time that goal was 10-3.
Loses the puck, but it's regained by Team Quay. Leslie, with a spinorama, passes it up to Button. Leslie regains the puck along the boards. Leslie follows the puck. Laquette wanted the puck, but now it's being played down low. Turnbull traps the puck with her skate. Johnston passes the puck up. Team Dupuis gains the zone. And it's taken back the other way, coast to coast. Pauline. And the puck is near Mashmeyer. Puck is being taken by Jenner the other way. The puck is on net. Ratu covers it up. Clark, who has two goals this evening. As we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, she just received her NCAA ring and her WCHA ring. Had a banner ceremony a few weeks ago where she hoisted the D1 trophy. Jenner plays the puck up ahead. Puck is taken away. Now number 11 for Black. Saunier came away with it. Former member of Canadiens de Montreal, the CWHL. Nurse played the puck ahead. Wisconsin Badger alum. Be offsides. Eldridge had the puck. Now Leslie passes it back to Fast. Fast regroups. Fast passes it ahead to Eldridge. Eldridge to Leslie. Leslie passes it to number 19, and that's a mad scramble in front of the net. Team Hefford regains control of the puck. Fast puts it on net, and it's caught by Mashmeyer. .717 left in the second. Team Hefford's leading 3-2. We have number 15, Dow, for the faceoff for Team Hefford. Dow against Turnbull. Dow keeps the puck in for Team Hefford. Puck is stripped away. Gosling with a pirouette. Now Turnbull over the blue line. Turnbull dangles, loses the puck. Pauline comes away with the puck. Puck is trapped against the boards. Now Laquette tried to play the puck through traffic. Mashmeyer does not know where the puck is as she's searching for it, and that'll be an attempt. As Mashmeyer went down, Clark tried to go top shelf. Mashmeyer turns the puck aside. Laquette brings the puck back the other way, and that's a hard hit. We have a little extracurricular with Johnson and Laquette. And Laquette will head toward the penalty box as Team Quay Dupuis, excuse me, heads to the power play with 6:11 left in the second. Jenner will be taking the face off for team Dupuis. I believe that was Nurse. It's for team Hefford. Puck is being pried along the board. Spooner does not win the foot race to retrieve the puck. Nurse with a spinorama. Stick was lost. Jenner retrieves the puck. Puck is being circled back by Fortino. Fortino backhands it to Gabel. Fortino plays it ahead, but the puck is intercepted. Puck is being played by Ratu. Ratu with a poke check, and it's stopped by Leslie's. That goal from far side point after Ratu poke checked it. That was a good one-timer there. And the game is all tied up at 3. This is a treat for Chicagoans because, and viewers around the United States, because we normally do not get to see Team Canada or any of the Canadian national team play. We apologize about the French pronunciations. Most of a misplay. Puck is played up to Saunier. Saunier looking for an open teammate in the slot. Ratu goes post to post. Puck is being turned the other way. Back in the slot as it crosses the slot to the near side board.
Team Dupuis goal number 36, Lauren Gable.
And that will be Gable.
Time of that goal is 5:25.
Who ties the game up for Team Dupuis. Puck ricochets off the far side board, drops it back to number 51. Puck now will be iced. Now will be Gosling to ice the puck. Doug Bach is going to take the face off. Team Dupuis. It's Stacy with a shot near the blue line. Saunier collides with Nurse, Gosling, and Clark. Clark has the puck, tried to pass it up to Dow. Laquette with a shot, and it goes through traffic, and that's a goal for Laquette from the blue line as it goes right through the five hole. A Mashmeyer. 3:59 left, and Team Hefford gets on the board and takes the lead. Eldridge against Jenner in the face-off circle. Neutral ice. Ratu backhands the puck, plays it out. Here comes Button, and that'll be a bar down goal for Hannah Button to put Team Hefford up a pair of goals. So we have 5-3. With 3:42 left in the second. And Mashmeyer taps the puck lightly, plays it to her teammate. Fortino plays the puck ahead to Johnston. Johnston with a shot, and it's kicked away by Ratu.
Team Hefford goal number four, Bridget Lockett. Assisted by number seven, Laura Stacy, and number
two. The puck is played up against the boards. A few players trying to unwedge the puck. Johnston with a shove. And Spooner was there as well. Bate plays the puck along the boards. Pauline looking for an open teammate. Bate could not get there. The collision mid ice. Fast. We'll back check. Plays the puck to Dow. Dow misplays the puck to Channel. Lafort puts the puck on Ratu, and Ratu saw the puck pop up. She didn't know where the puck went. Laquette attempted to take the puck away. Puck is being played out toward the neutral zone. Now number three for Team Black. LaRock chipped in the puck in deep. Fast pins a player against the boards. Puck is taken away by Nurse. Nurse loses the puck as it's stripped away from her. Good block as a ref went down as well. And LaRock almost has the puck. Jenner passes it to Gable. Laquette plays the puck ahead to Nurse. Nurse with Stacy on her wing, and she couldn't get the puck to her. Jenner back the other way. Jenner plays a puck one time opportunity and the puck is blocked. Here comes Stacy. Stacy with the backhand, but the puck did not get very far. Good stick by Eldridge to keep the puck in Team Hefford's offensive zone. Turnbull with a block. And the puck is being played on the far side corner.
1 minute remaining.
One minute remaining in the second period. Mickelson pirouettes. Puck is being brought the other way. Johnston moves around number 12 for Red. Is able to keep the puck. Puck is coming toward the other way. Leslie on Dow's wing. On number 27, and that'll be a whistle. Looks like we'll have a face-off. Right outside of Team Hefford's defensive zone, and it looks like we have a penalty coming up. So we're going to have a power play for Team Dupuis with 19 seconds left. So in the third period, Team Dupuis will start with a power play. Jenner with a face-off for Team Dupuis, and that took an odd bounce toward Ratu. Ratu covers it up. Jenner with a face-off again. Played in the near side hash marks. Spooner tried to play the puck in the slot, and that is not a goal. It went off the crossbar. Team Hefford is leading 5-3 going into the third. Stay tuned.
And at the end of the second period, we got Team Hefford 5 and Team Dupuis 3. Woo! such an amazing opportunity for the accomplished female athletes. Thank you. proud supporter of the PWHPA Dream Gap Tour, Duncan Wood, would like to thank you for attending the Magellan Corporation Women's Hockey Show that is here in Chicago. To thank for your support, 12 lucky fans have been selected to receive a Duncan gift card that will keep the pool filled up for the week ahead. Congratulations to our lucky winners.
Thank you.
And we are back for the final frame of this game. Team Hefford is winning 5-3. And Team Hefford will be in the penalty box starting the period. We'd like to thank our sponsors one more time. Magellan Corporation, Billie Jean King Enterprises. We'd also like to thank Adidas Hockey, Bauer, Dunkin' Donuts, the NHLPA, and BioSteel. Face-off underway. Pauleen and Jenner. Pauleen coming back in. It looked like she was kicked out. Pauleen against Jenner. Pauleen wins the face-off. Now number 12 rings the puck along the boards. And here comes Team Dupuis. That was Jenner playing it to Gable. Fortino passes the puck deep. Puck is playing behind Ratu. Puck is chipped along the boards, held in by Team Dupuis. Held in again by LaRocque. The puck finally trickles out. Gable will pass it to Jenner. Puck ricochets off the boards. That was number 27 for Red. 37. Now Nurse has the puck. Nurse battles to get the puck off her stick. She was unable to. So Team Dupuis comes away with it. Puck is being circled back. Dow passed it to Laquette. Saucer pass to the other end of the ice. That will be Mashmeyer. Puck is played up to Bach. Bach loses it. Laquette retrieves the puck. Played off the far side wall. Spots it out of the air from Laquette. Dow, 2-on-1 developing. Dow couldn't get the rebound. So Bach will come the other way with the puck. Backhand, no whistle. Mashmeyer caught the puck and let it go. Dow plays the puck ahead to Ambrose. Ambrose backhands it to Pauleen. Pauleen plays the puck toward the center. Puck is played in the center, or in the slot. Ambrose skates back to the blue line. Ambrose plays the puck in the slot. Puck is taken away. Now Rattray came away with it. Bate had the puck. Dow plays the puck over the blue line. Chanel played the puck up ahead. Puck is taken away. Now puck is being played back to number 5. That's Rougeau. Battle against the boards. Hard hit into the boards. Puck is being pried along the boards. Bach comes away with it for Team Dupuis. Puck trickles out to the neutral zone. Rougeau. Puck is being held behind Ratu. Turnbull charges toward a player. Puck is lost. Spooner rushes in to her offensive zone. Offsides. Touchdown in London town. 25-3. Team Hefford is leading. 16:09 in the third. Nurse comes away with the puck, puts it on net, and it's caught by Mashmeyer. Face off. Going to be toward the near side boards. It's kept in by Team Hefford. That was Stacy who kept the puck in. Turnbull pivots. Plays it to Spooner. Spooner plays it. Goes D to D. Plays it ahead to Johnston. Johnston couldn't get her stick on it because the puck was too out to handle. Puck was offsides. So there will be a face-off. Jenner against Pooline. Fast. Came away with the puck. The puck was blocked by a skate. Dow backhands it. Bette rushes for the puck. Dow retrieves it. We'll have to go pass it up as she tries to backhand it. A Mashmeyer. Pauline loses the puck to Jenner. Jenner to Rattray. Fortino, and that'll be a goal as it just tips off Rattray's glove. So it's 5-4 now, with 15:03 in the third. We will have the goal in a few minutes. It's going to be Jenner taking the face off. Eldridge. Jenner and Eldridge. Eldridge wins the face-off. Team Hefford carries the puck. Now Eldridge. Puck is stripped away. Jenner tried to tie the game up. No luck. And here comes Team Hefford back the other way. And it's kicked aside by Mashmeyer. Puck is played. It was Rattray. He's going for a line change.
Team Dupuis goal for number 19.
All new, all fresh Jenner. Legs. And that will be Jenner. Fresh legs for Team Dupuis. That was offsides. Excuse me, that was icing. So Bach will take the face off to Team Dupuis. Now LaRocque keeps the puck in. Puck is being taken out. It was kept in. That was Leslie who had the puck. Puck is being brought back the other way. Bach over the blue line, carries it through along the far side board. Tries to put the puck on Rattray, but is unable to. LaRocque passes it to Saunier. Saunier with a shot and it's wide. Gosling will get held up against the boards. Gosling tries to move the puck forward. Laquette comes away with the puck. Passes it up to Nurse. Nurse passes it up to Clark. Clark over the blue line. Clark has already had two goals and is looking for the hat trick. Nurse drops it back along the boards. Nurse looks for an open teammate, but the puck is stripped. Puck is played by Spooner. Spooner to Johnson. Johnson back to Spooner. Here comes Spooner with speed. And Rattray caught it. Tries to swat it away. The puck is in the slot. And the whistle blows just in time for Rattray to find the puck. Stop, puck will be, faceoff will be near the far side boards. Goes Turnbull with a faceoff. Johnson with an opportunity as Ratu comes all the way out. Dow fighting for the puck. Bette loses the puck and Spooner comes away with it. Spooner over the blue line, drops it back. Hard crash into the boards. Turnbull fights for the puck as she jousts for it. Fast gets pinned up along the boards. A couple pokes from Turnbull. And Ratu head to the bench. Player advantage. Here comes Eldridge. Eldridge pass to Pauline. Pauline dangles. And it's taken away by Turnbull, and there will be a delayed penalty. Score is 5-4 with 12:21 left in the third. Remember to stay tuned for game two this evening. Once we know the winner of this game, we'll have one member of the championship game for tomorrow. Hard hit into the boards. So player goes flying over Gosling. That will be Stacy who went flying over Gosling. Mickelson. Hard hit into the boards. Johnston has the puck as it was swatted away by Laquette. Nurse attempts to get her stick on it. Rougeau rushes back. D to D. Team Dupuis will have to regroup. Ratu plays the puck. Puck is lost behind Ratu. Puck is played up ahead over the blue line through the neutral zone. Wheels it to Bette. Bette over the blue line. Here comes Bette holding on to the puck. Cuts back. Looks for an open teammate. Has the puck stripped by Spooner. Fast. Play the puck to Ratu. Ratu plays it back to Fast. Fast looks for an open teammate, plays it to Ambrose. Ambrose had the puck ricocheted off the boards. Puck was chipped in from the glass. Ambrose plays it from the blue line. Ambrose looks for an open teammate. Puck is put on net just high and wide. No one in the slot for the rebound. Ratu will come all the way out of her net into the slot to play the puck. Fast regains the offensive zone, puts the puck on net, puck bounces. Puck is circled along the boards. Johnson attempts to steal the puck. Johnson comes away with it. Team Dupuis back to full strength. Hard hit into the far side boards. Puck put on Mashmeyer. Mashmeyer blocked it. LaRocque comes away with the puck. Passes it up ahead to Spooner. Spooner loses the puck. Foot race. And Spooner pins, believe that was Leslie, to the boards. Puck is being shoveled out from the boards. Cortino, a few other players looking for the puck. Looked like the puck had to be kicked out. Foot race for Stacy. Stacy has Mickelson on her wing. And Mashmeyer will get to the puck before anyone can get the rebound. Pauline will take the face-off along with number 12, Bach. Nurse tried to score a short side goal. Nurse took a tumble. Bach had the puck. Lafort regroups. Laquette plays the puck up to Nurse. Nurse the other way. Nurse puts the puck on net, but the puck is turned aside. Nurse will head to the bench. Puck is being played down low. Dow will get to the puck first. One time attempt by Pauline. Pauline couldn't get her stick fully on the puck fast. Attempted to get the puck through traffic. Hard hit against the boards. Pauline with a cross check. But the ref didn't call that. Looks like delayed penalty coming up. Pauline, an opportunity that'll be covered up just in time. It looks like we're going to head back to the power play.
When you write down your dream, there's a better chance it'll come true. Be sure to visit the Bauer Dream Wall to take a selfie and share your dreams.
I'd like to thank Bauer, another one of our sponsors. Team Hefford is leading 5-4 with 8:15 left. So Team Hefford will head back to the power play. Ambrose chips the puck hard. Puck goes deep. Puck is being played down low. Hard hit into the boards. Puck is being dug out. Ambrose has the puck. Ambrose looks for a lane. Mashmeyer closes the five hole just in time.
The PWHPA wishes to express thanks to its partners, Adidas, Duncan, NHLPA, Bauer, and BioSteel.
Puck kept in by Stacy. Stacy cuts back. Puck is backhanded by Mickelson. Stacy comes away with the puck. Nurse shoved along. It'll be caught. Clark with an opportunity. LaRock spins the puck along the boards. Will be turned aside. Clark plays the puck in deep. Ricocheted near the slot. Johnson with a spin goes down. One timer and that'll be caught. Will be turned aside. 6:58. Left in the third, Team Hefford leading 5-4.
Women hockey showcase hats, t-shirts, sweatshirts at the merchandise booth.
We have a very exciting game tomorrow. We'll see Team USA, Team Canada rematch. For now, we have Turnbull on the faceoff dot. Puck is played toward the neutral zone. Spooner got a stick on the puck. Ambrose comes away with the puck, wheels it coast to coast. Here comes Ambrose through the neutral zone, over the blue line. Someone got their stick on it. Turnbull weaves in and out. Puck is played fast. We'll get to the puck first. Ratu cuts back. And Dow loses the puck. Bette will retrieve it. Ambrose chips it in deep. Back to full strength. Team Hefford still leading. Fast pass the puck down low. Dow passes the puck ahead to Bette. Puck is being held in. Sonier. Passes the puck deep. Puck was lost at center ice. So team Dupuis will have to regain the puck. Bach with an opportunity to keep the puck in, but the puck went coast to coast. 5:31 left in the third. Team Hefford is leading 5-4. She said, where we going? And I set the moon. We ain't even make it to the room. She thought it was the ocean. It's just a pool. Jenner will take the face off against Clark. Clark wins the face off. However, one from Team Hefford could get their stick on it. Gosling. Puck is played to LaRock. Puck is lost. Now Clark passes it up to Stacy. Gosling plays it against the board. LaRock plays the puck behind Mashmere. One time attempt played in the slot. Scramble. No one could get their stick on it. Now Team Dupuis had the puck. It was played out to center. It'll be a whistle offsides. We have a very special guest for game two. Brianna Decker will be joining us for game two. Turnbull played the puck to Fast. Misplayed the puck. Clark, two-on-one opportunity. Bette is on her wing. Long pass to Dow. Dow has the puck. She plays it to Poulin. Puck is played through traffic. No one could get the rebound. Turnbull with a turn. Plays it through the neutral zone. Bette comes away with it, but it's intercepted by number 5. For Team Dupuis, that will be Ragu. Fortino with an opportunity as she played it in the slot. And that'll be kept by Ratu with 3:54 left. Team Hefford leading 5-4. Puck is played Team Hefford's defensive zone. Button comes up. Opportunity, but it's rung around the boards. Held in by Team Hefford. Puck is kept along the near side boards. Flung across to the far side boards now. 3:25 left in the third. Fortino fighting for the puck. Sonier tempted to have the puck as Nurse goes down. That'll be a tripping call. No cross check. A cross check call, so we have another power play.
The PWHPA will also like to express its thanks to Chicago
number
Partners.
9.
Sports Chicago, Fifth Third Arena, near Chicago
Blackhawks. Dow looking for an explanation from the ref. Puck is kept in by Dow. Dow playing keep away from Spooner. Puck bounced out. 3:03 left in the third. Clark had the puck down in the slot. Someone got a piece of the puck. Dow with another opportunity. Dow passes it ahead. Clark looking for the hat trick. Dow left a back check. Dow retrieves the puck, passes it up. Hard hip check. Ratu retrieves the puck fast. Be the first player to pick the puck up. Moves through the neutral zone, stops, waits for a teammate. Dow with a shot, but puck was wide. It will be Ambrose to Dow. Puck was intercepted. Johnston had the puck. It's met at center ice. Dow plays the puck in. 1:56 left in the third. Poulin passes it to the blue line, but the puck trickles under Fast stick. Fast looking for an open teammate, regroups, plays the puck ahead. Puck ricochets off the boards to Leslie. Leslie fights for the puck. Gable. Mickelson with a hard shot. Power play almost done with 1:15 left, and that'll be caught. No whistle. Mashmeyer lets it go. Plays it ahead for Rattray. The puck is played toward the far side. For the near side of the wall now. Ratu looking for the puck, tracking it down, 46 seconds left. Team Hefford leading. Looks like Team Hefford be in the championship game tomorrow unless Johnson tries to tie it up. No luck, but Team Play keeps it in. Johnston will retrieve the puck. Empty net. Extra attacker, Jenner. Passes the puck to Fortino. Looks for a lane, and that'll be tied up with 6.5 seconds. Looks like we might be going into overtime. Looks like it went off someone's stick. Referees will be examining that. They haven't changed the score yet. Poulin, I believe it's Jenner, asking for an explanation. All that I'm wishing for my friends, nobody makes it from my hands. I had to bust up the silence. Looks like there's a conversation right below us. Selena is looking like she's liking the answer, but one more time, but I love. I have powers taking a hold on me. I need one dance, got a Hennessy. One more time, but I go. I have powers taking hold on me. So it's no goal.
The call on the ice is no goal.
So no goal, so 6.5 seconds. Team Hefford still leads 5-4. Face-off will be near the near side boards. Turnbull against Poulin. 6.5 seconds left in the third. Almost a tie game. Puck is being played against the boards. And that'll do it. Team Hefford will be going to the championship game tomorrow. I'm Natalie Bober on Play-by-Play. Thank you to CBC, Choyle Brown, our camera person, and our sponsors, Magellan Corporation, Billie Jean King Enterprises, Adidas Hockey, Bauer, Dunkin' Donuts, the NHLPA, and BioSteel. I hope everyone enjoyed this game as much as I enjoyed calling it. One final time for Fifth Third Arena. Team Hefford, 5. Team Dupuis, 4. Team Hefford will be playing in the championship game tomorrow. Don't forget to tune in at 7 p.m. as Team Granado takes on Team Ruggiero at Fifth Third Arena in Chicago. Thank you for watching.